Hi guys, welcome to Endoca. My name is Demi and today we're going to be discussing terpenes. This is a video you guys have requested a lot. It's a video that we believe very strongly in because we're big supporters of whole plant cannabis and CBD extracts, meaning containing all the vital molecules that are found naturally in the hemp or cannabis plant, which includes terpenes. There are over 400 different compounds found in the cannabis plant and over 200 of them are terpenes. Terpenes are essentially molecules found in plants, flowers and fruit that give it their distinctive smell. However, terpenes aren't just present because they make things smell nice to us. Terpenes essentially act as a plant's natural pest repellent, and it also helps plants survive when there's really, really high temperatures. If you're watching this video, you probably already know that cannabis has a huge array of different terpenes. But did you know you can find the same kinds of terpenes in everyday plants and herbs? Terpenes are produced within the cannabis plant inside the trichomes, the same place where the cannabinoids are. Despite terpenes only making up 1% of collected cannabis samples, they contribute to about 10% of trichome content. They also evaporate at high temperatures, which is why cannabis smells the most pungent first thing in the morning. And this is why when we harvest our plants, we make sure that we harvest first thing in the morning to make sure we retain as many terpenes as possible. There's an interesting amount of information regarding terpenes out there. Steep Hill Labs have even suggested that the difference between an indica and sativa comes down to their terpenoid content. They were even quoted in saying, if a sample has over 0.5% myrcene, it will have indica or couch lock effects. If a sample has less than 0.5%, it will have a soaring sativa effect. Interesting fact, caryophyllene is an extremely heat resistant terpene, which is why in decarboxylated versions of cannabis, it's the most abundant terpene found. This is why stiffer dogs are trained to detect it when searching for cannabis. Okay, so terpenes smell kind of nice, but can they do anything for our bodies? As it so happens, science has backed up what aromatherapists have known for years, that terpenes can result in physiological changes in our bodies. Even Ethan Russo, a very well-known cannabis scientist, has been quoted in saying that terpenoid components in concentrations above 0.05% are of pharmacological interest. He also carried out a study on mice looking at the effect of terpenes in animal models. Mice exposed to terpenoid odors inhaled from ambient air for 1 hour demonstrated profound effects on activity levels, suggesting a direct pharmacological effect on the brain, even at extremely low serum concentrations. This kind of research makes it pretty clear to us that terpenes aren't just nice added extras or added bonuses when it comes to a cannabis extract. So let's take a look at some of the most common terpenes and the ones you're most likely to find in indica extracts. Myrcene is the most abundant type of terpene found in cannabis and gives cannabis that earthy, spicy, clove-like aroma. It can also be found in plants like wild thyme, hops, lemongrass, basil, and even mango. Some of the purported health benefits are that it can help with the effects of diabetes, is a pain reliever, and also a sedative. And according to Foundation Canna, it has also been shown that the myrcene alters the blood-brain barrier, favoring the penetration of cannabinoids in the brain and increasing the effects. Next terpene we're going to talk about is limonene. Limonene is one of the most common terpenes found in nature. If you ever noticed a lemony or orangey citrus flavor in any of your hemp oils, that's because of the limonene. For example, you know citronella, the things that they make citronella candles out of that ward against mosquitoes? That has limonene. However, obviously it's not related at all to the lemon tree, the lemon plant. It's a flower, but it has limonene. Some of the potential therapeutic benefits that have been researched in regards to limonene have been its ability to dissolve cholesterol-containing gallstones, relieving heartburn, causing cancer cell death, being anti-inflammatory, and has both antibacterial and antifungal properties. Mood-enhancing and anti-anxiety effects have also been noted in animal and human models. One small study exposed patients with depression to citrus aromas, and not only did they see the depression reduce, 9 out of 12 of the patients were able to stop their antidepressant medication. The next terpene we're going to talk about is pinene. This terpene is commonly found in pine resins and conifers. Interestingly enough, pinene is also actually found in insects and is actually part of their internal communication system. When we think of pine, a lot of us think of cleaning liquids or detergents, and there's a reason for that. Pinene has found to be antimicrobial. It's also been found to be a bronchodilator when inhaled at low concentrations. Not only that, but pinene has also been found to have anti-inflammatory properties. In a 2014 study on humans, it was actually found to be a potential candidate for a new osteoarthritis drug. The next terpene we're going to talk about is linalool. Lavender has been well known for a long time to aid sleep, relaxation, and have sedative effects. But now we know why. It's most likely because it contains the terpene linalool. Linalool has also been found to have anti-inflammatory properties and analgesic properties. The legend goes that lavender's healing properties were discovered when a perfume maker burnt himself and plunged his hand into a vat of lavender oil and found that it really helped with the burn. Linalool also appears to have anti-seizure properties. The last terpene we're going to talk about today is carophyllene, and I'm sorry if I said that wrong, but it's a very difficult terpene to pronounce, so please correct me if I am mistaken. This is probably the terpene with the most pharmacological potential. This terpene can be found in black pepper, leafy greens, and of course cannabis. It's unique amongst all the different terpenes because this terpene actually activates the CB2 receptor sites. These compounds are referred to as cannabinomimetic. This explains why this terpene is known to have immunomodulating effects as well as anti-inflammatory effects, with a study showing that it's even more effective than synthetic cannabinoids. Similar to our wonderful cannabinoids, this terpene is known to be a powerful antioxidant, with one paper saying that it had tremendous therapeutic potential. Not only that, but it's been found to ease anxiety and depression, stimulate the cell death in cancer cells, and may even be a possible treatment for alcoholism. Even though most of this research has been done on animal models, its anti-inflammatory and antioxidant properties mean it has exciting potential in the realm of research. Essentially, the presence of all these terpenes plus other cofactors and cannabinoids make up what researchers refer to as the entourage effect. Full spectrum or whole plant extracts are also the kinds of cannabis-based medicines that are showing the most therapeutic potential, even compared to synthetic or isolated cannabinoids. And according to Ethan Russo, he believes that terpenes may make up a very, very crucial part of this entourage effect and have a contributing role to the therapeutic benefits of medicinal cannabis products. As Aristotle put it, the whole is greater than the sum of its parts. However, whole plant extracts are not a viable option for pharmaceutical companies who are racing to patent isolated cannabinoids and synthetic cannabinoids. In the end, it's up to us as consumers to demand whole plant medicine, or at least demand to have the option. In any case, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video about terpenes, and I hope we shedded some light on the different kinds of terpenes that are in our products and the different kinds of therapeutic value they bring to CBD and whole plant cannabis extracts. We'll see you for the next video. Bye.